Let's open up DNS. So I'm going to click on start. I'm going to go inside Windows Administrative Tools. And within here, I'm going to locate DNS and I'm going to click on DNS. I'm going to load this up. We are going to expand our server. Let's go to forward lookup zone, double click on that, and you're going to go and locate your domain. Open that up and you should see like a crap load of records. Like my lab is super small, but most likely you might have like thousands. I've seen companies with thousands of records. They don't have scavenging and aging enabled, so they have like a lot of stale records in here. So I'm going to go to file, going to open, and we're going to the desktop, and we're going to open up this PowerShell script. I'm not going to go over it with you guys, but again, I did find this content here. I found this PowerShell script online. The only thing that I changed is line 30 of where I want to drop the CSV file. Now, I'm going to do a Control A to select everything, and I'm just going to do F8 or just click on Run Selection. Because I don't have a lot of records in DNS, so it should be quick for you. If you have like thousands of records, it should take some time. And to enable that feature is super easy. So within your DNS manager, you want to click on View and you want to click on Advanced. Once you click on Advanced, you should see in this little area here, a couple of things might show up. But let's say within my domain, within the A records right here, I'm just going to refresh real quick. Just refresh it just for the hell of it. Now, when I double click on my intermediate CAA record, let's double click on it and look at that. Tells you your domain. For me, btnhd.edu, we want to right click on that folder. We need to go into properties. Within properties, right, the first tab, which is general, I'll show you real quick. There goes the option, aging. By default, 7 days, it's not turned on. Let's enable it. You are able to make modifications on the days. If you don't want days, you could do hours. Like, oh shit, you really don't want to do hours. I would say days. It's all up to you. I can't tell you what's best practice here. It all depends on your environment. Let me get a little bit of water. Right? All depends on you. By default, Microsoft sets or kind of says this is what, you know, is best for your environment. I think in general, 7 days is throughout globally when you're configuring this, but you are able to change and make modifications depending on your requirements for your 9 to 5. So I'm gonna leave it at 7 days and we are going to click OK and that's it. Boom, done. We're gonna right click on that and we're going to go into properties. Okay. And if you pay attention, let's close this up. If you right click, you are able to do, when you right click on the server node, it's going to say set aging scavenging for all zones. But let's go to properties and we're going to go into advanced. And within advanced, you have the option right here to enable automatic scavenging on stale records. Hopefully I'm saying that word. I feel like it's so early in the morning right now. But by default, it's not turned on. So we're going to enable it. And again, Microsoft gives you a period of 7 days. You are able to change it to hours. I don't really recommend for hours.